Hey, we've got a great, awesome sunset out there right now, Amanda. Look at that bright red. We've got it from there up towards Daytona Beach, all across Central Florida. We've got some pretty sunset pictures, and we have gotten quite a slew of them over the last couple of days. There's the city beautiful for you right now, gorgeous looking shot, not even a cloud in the sky. But those temperatures are dropping and dropping quickly right now, so if you have Saturday night plans, be prepared to have that jacket. In fact, we've got freeze warnings in effect for Sumter County, on into Osceola, and on into the Polk County area, as temperatures here are expected to drop at or below freezing. Now let's talk about what's going on here. We've got one front down to the south, got high pressure here. We've got another front coming in late Sunday. We're in this northwesterly flow pattern. That's why we've been locked in with temperatures in the 50s and 60s for highs and 20s, 30s, and 40s for lows for almost 2 weeks now. And if you take a look at the upcoming pattern outside of Sunday and Monday, we're going to be right back in the 50s and 60s, and you're going to see that on that 7-day forecast. So if you like the cool weather, you don't have to jettison out of town. You're going to be in pretty good shape here. It's 48 currently right now in Ocala as the sun is setting. It's going to be very interesting to see the numbers here in 1 hour from now. It's probably going to be a good 5-degree drop in temperatures because the air is so dry. 50 in Sanford, 53 Cocoa Beach, and look at Melbourne, 48 with a dew point of 18. So realistically, there's plenty of room for that air temperature to drop, and it is going to drop very quickly here over the next 2 to 3 hours, and things will begin to stabilize in the temperature department. Look at where we are, 5 to almost 15 degrees cooler than this time yesterday behind that front that came through late last night and early this morning. And there's that temperature trend, 35 degrees by midnight up in Ocala. Look at downtown Orlando falling into the upper 30s by the midnight hour. Oh, we're not done yet. Let's head up towards Daytona Beach. Look at those numbers, upper 30s as well in Daytona Beach. So the overnight final lows right around 29, 30, 31 here in Marion County. A little bit warmer south than it is, but there will be some frost around. The air is dry, so that will limit the amount of frost, but we do believe that there will be some frost in the outlying areas and even potentially a freeze in and around the Keenesville area, one of normally our colder spots. So we got a frosty start, no doubt about that. But the all-time record low is not in jeopardy for Melbourne. Got a really cool picture this afternoon of the snow that fell Sunday, tomorrow, back in 1977. I want you to check that out tonight at 10 and 11. A little disturbance going by on Sunday. Could be a brief shower. Monday, Martin Luther King Day, probably the warmest day over the next week. Another front arrives on Tuesday. We cool it right back down. So let's take a look now at your updated 7-day forecast. Flipping out those panels, areas of frost in the morning, 38, nice warm up by lunchtime, mid-afternoon highs in the upper 60s to near the 70-degree mark. Most of us getting at or above the 70-degree mark there on Monday. Here comes that next front on Tuesday, and then look at that next cold snap, Amanda. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, there are no 70s, no 80s. It's cold.